Hi, this is Mahi. In the last section, we understand to how to control the robot, but without a very strong objective. Our objective was not to hit the obstacles. But today, we're going to have a simple objective that we're going to solve a maze. And for solving a maze, you have to do exploration. More than not hitting the walls or obstacles, you have to have an intention to do more explore in the map. So a simple and very useful way to explore the field is the Monte Carlo. You can read about this, and you can find the code of Monte Carlo here in the C1 example. It's not complete. You have to complete the previous sections and use the code from the previous sections to understand this code, and also complete the to-dos in this code as a practice. So this is a complete practice for solving a maze, and by completing this practice and exercise, you should see a performance of robot as good as the performance we put in the sample code. And if you tune the parameter, you might see even a better performance. So I'm running the sample code once again to show you the final result of this section and which improvement you can give to this code in the future. After this tutorial for working on this simulator, it's just a matter of the rules and matter of the scenarios that you have to complete. So it's a closed loop control that you need to define your objectives, and you need to understand what rules in the game will apply and use those objective and rules to get the higher score. So this is a simulator we run, and this is a client, and I want to run the client sample. So I uncomment in the sample and run the client, and then run the server. So now you can see the robot is moving. For example, I make it a more challenging task for the robot. You don't need this. So this is looks like the final code that if you complete the practice would see. And remember that we use many number in the code, like how close to the object you have to turn, or how fast you have to move, or you have to turn. So you can change those number in the code and get a better performance. This robot is trying to understand the field and explore all the sections, but the way it's exploring is not very efficient, you know. So you have to think about the more efficient way of exploring all the map. And this map is actually one of the most complicated maze in this game. So in the simpler maze, maybe this algorithm works without any problem. But in a complex maze like this, you need to work and come up with the more advanced scenario. So yeah, that's it for now. I wrap up this session. Have a good day.